Chapter 18. At the Races.
In England, double yellow lines at the edge of the road may mean no parking at any time. Arthur's car was at the police station. So while Sheila and Jennifer went for a swim, Arthur went round to the police station and collected his car. He had to pay £40, and the policeman on duty said one of his tyres was worn almost smooth. This was illegal. Arthur had to buy a new one that day. And so Arthur had less money for the rest of his holidays. The Sunday trip was more expensive than he first thought. On the way home, Jennifer was even more unpleasant than before. The traffic was worse on the way back. On Sunday evenings in the summer, the traffic is always heavier than usual. In fact, it's the worst time of the week. Sometimes they went no faster than 5 miles an hour, and in some places they went even more slowly. When they passed Salisbury, however, conditions were better, but they didn't arrive home until after midnight, much later than they expected. Arthur didn't do much for the rest of his holidays. He spent a lot of time working on his car. He bought some paint, and at the end of the week it was cleaner, brighter, and more attractive than it was before. Jennifer's friend Bob, the engineering student from Reading University, knows a lot more about cars than most people in Applefield, and he came round to the Newtons on several evenings and helped Arthur. They did all the necessary jobs, and finally the car worked much better. On his last Saturday at home, Arthur, Jennifer, Bob and Sheila went to a race meeting at Fetlock Park, near Applefield.
You know all about horses, don't you, Bob? Arthur doesn't know anything about them.
I like that nice black one over there. His coat's smoother, and he's got a sweeter face than all the rest.
Has he ever won a race?
Let's see. That's Mark Time. No, he's never won a race in his life. Don't put any money on him.
I've got a race card here, and Bright Thursday seems to be the best bet.
Yes, he's the favourite.
Oh.
That's him over there, the grey one. He's bigger than the others and faster, of course.
Aren't the jockeys tiny? Look at that one. He's smaller than me.
Of course he is. Most people are smaller than her.
Shut up, Jennifer. Don't be rude.
I don't think she heard.
Well, have you decided anything yet? Are you going to put any money on this race? If so, I'll go and put it on for you.
I'm going to put £1 on Mark Time. He's the nicest horse I've ever seen. He looks sad. He's a bit like you, Arthur. I expect he's as slow as Arthur as well.
Jennifer, you're the rudest girl I've ever met. I like Darling Mary. I'm going to put my last £2 on her.
Do you hear that, Sheila? Arthur likes Darling Mary.
What are you going to put your money on, Jennifer?
I haven't got any money.
Come on, Arthur. Where's your money? We haven't got much time.
Here you are.
Let's go over there. We can see the race better there.
Come on, Bright Thursday! You haven't got much farther to go!
I can't see my horse!
I can, it's right at the back! It's the slowest horse in the race!
Look at Darling Mary! She's going faster now! She's just passing Bright Thursday! She's gonna win! Come on! Faster! Faster!
Ah, look! She's won!